Hey, horse people. There was no wind out here until I hit this mic. And I'm not kidding you. I mean, it was dead calm. And as soon as I hit the mic, the wind blew. And I've got a piece of foam over the mic. So quit telling me to put something over the mic. So it's tie time with Buddy and Ransom. So first I got to get some fly spray on them. And then I'll talk about the horrible rescue I just went to. So I'm gonna get the fly spray, because I know Ransom don't like it. Bottle. I need to get a damn glass squirt bottle. This thing just keeps shrinking. So during the day it heats up, swells up with air. At night as it cools, it shrinks down and mashes this, and it won't come back. So let me get a little Ransom here. He's like, but I don't like it. Okay, so on a fly spray, people were saying that I shouldn't have been so hard on the suggestion of using a rag to put fly spray on. Buddy's checking my pockets. Police, hands up, don't shoot, buddy. I don't have any drugs on me, carrots, apples. I'm clean, dude. You wanna check the front? So what I was saying is, hang on, let me wipe my hands on the grass. That usually gets this junk off. Rubs off the legs, might let them go pretty good. So, somebody said I was being too hard because somebody said they should use a rag. And I go, I don't want to use a rag. I'm not letting my horse train me to where I can't use a spray bottle. He needs to get used to the damn spray bottle. Now, I didn't say you shouldn't use a rag. I just told you why I'm not going to let my horse force me to use a rag and not use that opportunity to make him accept the spray bottle. Like I said, you can put water in a spray bottle. I don't think a horse ought to be jumping around if you get a spray bottle. You may want to squirt him down with some pink shampoo or something to loosen up his tail, and he needs to get used to a spray bottle. You may want to lighten his tips on his mane or put hairspray on his forelocks. I don't know what these women do with horses anymore, but I'm not going to use a rag because my horse is afraid of a spray bottle. Now, for the face area, putting it on a rag is a good idea because you shouldn't spray it around the face. I usually either spray it on my hands or brush them and then brush their face. After I spray it on their body, I brush them with a brush. It'll get on the end of the brush and then I'll brush their face. That way I'm not spraying it in their eyes. So either one of those things will work for the eyes or for the face area. So let me, so I just went out. And you guys know I rag on freaking rescues because I have yet to find a good one. Except the other day I talked about on my live show, I talked about, what's that farms? Sunnybrook? What was that farms in New York? Damn. Yesterday I couldn't remember her name and I remember the damn name of her rescue. Whatever, you guys put it in the thing. Whatever it is, it's something farms. Here, shit, I think I added it in my damn phone. Hang on, let me open my thing. Her name is Dawn, who runs the place. So I end up calling Dawn. But let me see what her rescue is called. Oh, don't tell me I didn't add it in here. Oh my God, you're killing me, dude. Rosemary Farms, that's it. Rosemary Farms. Shit. So Dawn runs that rescue up there, and when she started it, I mean, it was literally, I think she started with three or four horses, went to a couple sell auctions. She told me the other day she has almost 100 horses. She bought more property across the street, so she's got more horses. And so I end up calling her after live saying, hey, I kind of mentioned you on the thing and I couldn't find your number and I forgot your name. And we hadn't talked in I don't know how many years, but we end up talking for like 3 hours. Talking about rescues and Mr. T, because she actually visited me. I don't know where the hell I was at when she visited me, but she visited me. I don't think it's in Texas. I think she visited me in California, and she got to lunch with Mr. T, but I have no idea where the hell we were at or where she did it. But anyway, maybe it was checked. I don't know. So anyway, she knew Mr. T and actually lunged him and felt his power and how pretty he was and everything. So, you know, she didn't hear that Mr. T had died. So we talked for 3 hours about rescues, and you know, I told her, I said, man, everyone I go to, they're trashy and they just take money and they want money and they don't care for the horse. And she started telling about her contract. She sounds like she's got a great contract. Somebody's got a rescue, you need to call her, because she's like got a contract to where you can't sell, you can't give away, you can't do anything. Once you get a horse, they get the first ride. I mean, it sounds like she's doing a lot of things right. And you know, if y'all, buddy, am I going to have to shorten up your tie, boy? Because you're going to keep messing with poor little Rank. Buddy, don't make me walk over there, boy. I'll hit you in the head with this coffee cup. It says come and take it. You're going to take it across the head, boy. So right now I'm standing in the sun because of this freaking, it's hot as hell. Let me move over here in the shade. So there's a big solar flare today. And I don't even know if I'm in a camera. But there's a big solar flare happening today, and you don't want to be in the sun like between 11 and 2 or 4, because it's a nasty solar flare. I mean, the video, I posted it on Twitter. My Twitter is Horsey Guy, and it's not Horsey Guy with an E, it's Horsey Guy without an E. H-O-R-S-Y-G-U-Y, Horsey Guy. So that's my Twitter, and I tweeted out that video on the solar flare. Because it was just supposed to be massive. I mean, this video I watched, he was talking about causing earthquake and tremors and causing people to be dizzy who are sensitive, and changing the magnetic fields coming in, and then changing the magnetic. I mean, it was just supposed to raise havoc. He didn't say it was going to knock out cell phones and do all that, but it's a pretty massive solar flare. And he actually shows a video of a planet or a star or a meteor, whatever the hell it was, something the size of the Earth, swinging around and hitting the freaking sun. And when it did, it caused this huge flare out and this huge flare out here. And that's what we're getting. So it was a pretty cool little video. So I'm trying to stay out of the sun. So I got these two guys tied up because I just got back from that rescue. I took my boots off to tell you what kind of rescue this was. I took my boots off when I got here and I put them onto the horse trailer because I'm not wearing them anywhere on my property until I spray them down with bleach. I mean, it was just, I got a real quick video of the horses. I mean, and I feel like it's my fault those freaking Mustangs were locked up because he had them in a round pen. And I mean, they were literally 2 feet in shit in this round pen. And I mean, I've seen round pens. The Mexicans like to do that because they say it makes good footing. So they never clean out their round pens. I've worked with quite a few places where Mexican trainers, and their round pens are always full of crap. As it dries, it makes this mulch, and it makes it harder for them to walk. It's almost like thick sand, but it's lighter than sand. And so this round pen had 2 feet of crap in it, and of course it's been raining in Texas for 14 days, so it's like it was just slushy, muddy crap. No food. The horses were standing. I was just like, I walk up there and I go, these are the four Mustangs? She goes, well, these two, the other two are out there. And I'm just like, really? It was just absolutely disgusting. I was so pissed. I wanted to just turn around and leave. But I looked, I asked some questions, and it just freaking, it just disgusts me every time I try to help a so-called rescue. And it turns out to be some crazy-ass border woman wanting to make money. Or this guy happens to be a guy with his wife, and they're making all kind of money taking horses in and supposedly boarding them and feeding and caring for them when in fact they're just collecting money. And it was just disgusting. All the horses' ribs were showing. Had like 80 different horses running around, dragging rope, halters on, fence sticking out everywhere. I mean, it was just, I was like, I don't even want to walk out here myself. I don't want to bring my tools out here. I mean, I didn't say that, but I was just like, it was so disgusting. I drove like an hour and 10 minutes to get there. I wasted an hour listening to all the excuses, and then I drove back, and it's just like every damn time I get mixed up with one of these rescues, and I'm sorry if I got kids watching, but it just pisses me off. It's the same damn story. People making money off abusing freaking horses, and nobody gives a shit. So back to when I was talking to Dawn at her rescue, and I told her I was going to go to this place. And I told her, you know, the first thing the guy tells me, this is a clue. First thing the guy tells me when I call is when I'm going to go there work horses. He says, well, I just want you to know I got no problem with what you do. So if you want to tie them up or throw them on the ground, whatever, whatever happens out here stays out here. I just want you to know that. And I was like, really, dude? You're saying that to freaking me? You don't know who I am? That's because most idiots probably in Texas, that's how they train horses. So I was like, look, dude, I don't tie up horses. And I said, I videotape when I work with horses. So there ain't no, I ain't hiding nothing. He goes, well, I just want you to know anything that happens out here stays out here, so don't worry about it. What kind of people you think are working out there? What kind of business you think that sets? And he's getting paid money to keep these four Mustangs and supposedly work with them. It's just freaking disgusting. It just ruins my day to see horses living like that. I gotta come out. I already washed my hands. And the little Mustangs were just darling. I mean, like I said, I took a quick little video. Maybe I'll slide it in at the end here, a picture or something, on what the two little Mustangs were locked up in. The other two were out in the pasture. She said she had 85 acres. Of course, it ain't hers. It's her great-grandmother's grandmother, father. But, you know, it's same irresponsible people that get land for free, and they figure out, I can make money on horses. And it was just a disgusting place. I don't know how I'm going to work with it. But Don was telling me, because of the comment he made and because I went out there and he was kind of like, well, it's too muddy right now and you don't want to come out now and you want to wait. And she goes, you know what? I wouldn't be surprised if they still don't have the horses and they're just charging board. I go, really? Because evidently the rescue pays these people to rescue horses. So you're giving money to a rescue. They're paying other people to watch the horses, and all they are is abusing the horses. I mean, when you see this video, you're going to say, that's what a rescued horse looked like? I think the horses were better off at BLM when they were getting beat by BLM. It's disgusting. So anyway, I gotta figure out what I'm going to do with that, whether I'm going to make a video and send it to the lady that runs the rescue, whether I'm just going to just say, I don't want to get involved, I'm out of it. It just freaking so pisses me off. And I ain't met one damn, except Don's, one rescue that was above board and did what they were supposed to. And, well, anyway, Rosemary Farms up in New York, if you want to give to a rescue, she does it right, and she's got a lot of horses, and they get good care. So, anyway, so I came back here, and I figured I'd tie these guys up out of the sun. They're in the shade. The heat's up. I'd make them give some tie time, and I'm going to just mess with them a little bit. So I put a couple things in the car that I was going to work with them with, and I haven't pulled out a plastic bag on Mr. Ransom to see how he does. So let me go get my plastic bag out of the car. Uh-oh, it's trouble time, boys. Tell you what kind of rescue that place was. I was out there for maybe 30 minutes to 45 minutes. I drove back with my windows down and my car still has like 20 flies in it. I just went in there and there's flies everywhere still. And I was parked far away from where the horses were kept. So, what do we got here? I got the whip. I got my poker. When you're working with wild Mustangs, if they have this isn't for jabbing a horse. Everybody sees this and goes, dude, you're going to jab a horse. I can put pressure on a horse and make them move, but this hook right here helps me hook their halter at a distance if I need to hook that halter or hook the lead rope. Sometimes when you work with wild Mustangs, they're dragging that rope they put on at BLM, and so you can't really get close enough, but I can move this along the ground a little bit, hook that rope to where I get a hold of that rope. But otherwise, it's just a pointer. Feels kind of hard. He doesn't like that. Because it's kind of hard. Buddy don't care. He can't even feel it through his fat. So if there was a Mustang either in a horse that I couldn't grab in a horse trailer or through a fence, I could reach up here like so, hook this halter, and then pull him in. So I can either hook the rope or I can actually hook the halter and pull them in. Come on. Good boy. So that's why I like that little hook. And these are called a show cattle or something. It's for show cattle. They use them for cows or show cow. A cow prod, a show cattle prod, some shit. I don't know what the hell it is. And then we have a whip. So let's see what he does with just the sound. So that's not too bad. Getting ears for him, buddy don't care. So now we're gonna try to crack it. So he's kind of getting back, he's not too good with that. So I'm gonna go back to what he's good with, the whipping. And now we'll come over here and rub him with it and see if he'll. Okay, so he don't want anything to do with this. So instead of walking up to him high to where it's a bigger threat, I want to make it small and low and non-threatening. If I walk up to him like this, say smell it, smell it, smell it, it's going to cause him to go back. So I need to make this low and small, and I'll put it on the other side of my body to make it even smaller so it's not to him. He knows this. I'm going to get him to take a step forward. He's like, dude, what are you doing with that whip? Now I'm bringing it back up. Let him have a smell of it. He's not too sure about it. Like, dude, that was making a lot of noise. Now we'll go ahead and touch him with it. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. Pressure, release. People lose the thing and think pressure is only contact or physical. It's any movement. Right now, I'm putting pressure on him a little bit. Now I'm putting more pressure. And I never touched him. I don't like the way he's standing. Come on up here. I know, it's scary. I know, it's all right. So because he didn't like the noise in front of him, he's really not going to like it behind him. But when I do it behind him, if he spooks, he's going to go forward. So he's less likely to pull. So I'm going to get back behind him here and make some noise. Ransom ain't too relaxed. Can everybody see that Ransom is not relaxed? Is it just me seeing that Buddy doesn't care and Ransom does care? Okay, so Ransom is what I would, if I had to rate 1 to 5 or 1 to 10, 1 to 5 I would give him maybe a 3 on the whip. 1 to 10 I'll give him a 5. So he's not what I would call whip savvy. So let's see if he's bag savvy. Actually, he looks a little better with the bags. So all I do is take an old whip. I don't own one of these. I never bought one of these. I found it in a trash can. Somebody threw it away. It wasn't hurting our horse enough, so they got rid of it. And then I just tie some plastic bags. Now, some people don't cut the bottoms off. I cut the bottoms off the plastic bags. I just go like this and cut the bottoms off. That way the wind blows through them easier. And then I don't get the big balloon thing when I'm moving it. It moves more fluid and easy. Let's go see how they're doing. Maybe I should turn, make sure they're still in camera. We'll move a little bit further back. So we'll do Buddy first. Is Buddy being here first make it different? I mean, half a dozen one or the other. I'm not sure it makes a difference. Having another horse probably makes him feel a little more comfortable, but I don't know if he connects. If this horse is okay with it, I should be okay with it. Because horses that watch people ride don't let you get on their back just because you ride him. So I don't think there's a connection that if this horse lets me do the bag, then it'll be okay with me. So I'm gonna slowly give him a little pressure and let him check this out a little bit. And he seems pretty good with it. He's not too bad. He's more concerned about that whip than he is these bags, which is okay. I mean, that's... Hi, little Ransom. Pretty good poopy there. cut this grass tomorrow. So hopefully the sun today and tomorrow will dry this off. So getting rid of that poop quick will help keep down flies also. So Ransom looks like he's pretty good with this. So he did okay. The whip, I think he could do some more work on. Fly spray, he did better today than he did the other day. Where's that little plastic cone? Let me go stick these up back in their home. And I'll come out with another toy. So, another cool video, if you want to go watch it, is Smarter Every Day. I think the guy's name is Jason. He's a good dude. He does some great scientific stuff. But he did a video on a helium balloon floating in a car and a weight hanging. And when he floored the car, the weight went back like it should, but the helium balloon went forward. And he explains why that happened. It's pretty cool. Good little video. I love videos that kind of show me that I don't know what the hell I'm talking about. But anyway, so this little flag right here is metal and it's pretty heavy. And I don't remember where I got it, but it's all metal and it's got a heavy duty ring up top. It makes a little different noise than the plastic bag. Almost a little popping. Because it's metal, if a horse comes up, an aggressive horse, and I pop him with this metal across the bridge of the nose, he'll get back. He won't come in. But because it's metal, if I get over there and mess around, swing it, and I accidentally hit him, it's going to freaking hurt. So, and this is just one of those little cones I got at the 99 cent store. And I told that video, remember where I took Buddy and he was giving rides to little kids? And I turned around and there was a little kid with a big long balloon hitting Buddy in the back legs. Just doing this right behind Buddy. So I don't know how he's going to take this. Looks okay. Let's see if a little kid walked behind him and hit him. I'll give him some release. He looks a little tense. Okay, that's a little too much pressure for him. Did y'all see that? See, when I did it, I didn't want to stop immediately, so I kept moving it. It kept pressure, but I stopped the banging. I could tell he was about to go, that's too much pressure. So this is too much pressure here, but it may not be here. So depending on where you put the pressure, the horse will tell you if it's too much or not enough. If I did that hard and made that sound on his chest, you saw him, he was like, whoa, I don't like that, I'm going to move back. But I just did it on his back, and he was like, I'm okay with that. I did it on his butt, and he was okay with that. He's not real good with this, so I don't want him pulling away. So I'm gonna make him accept this. Because he didn't show a fear with his. This is a difference between a fear, I'm scared of it, and I don't want you messing with me. Can you see the difference? This was, I don't want you doing that. That's why I picked up his rope and go, no, no. You don't get to tell me no. It's one thing if you're scared and you can't handle it. It's something else if you tell me no, I don't want you to do it. That's different. And of course, Buddy didn't tell me either way. See that flinch? I went too fast by his eye. I went to where I wanted to pet the forehead, and his eye went, whoa, dude, why are you coming in so fast? That was my fault. That's why when people go, this horse is flinchy, he's scared. He got scared right there because I didn't go in like I should have from the front and move up and pet him softly. I went in like he was Buddy, and I just reached for his forehead too quick, and he wasn't used to that, and he went, whoa, what's going on? Why? But now he's kind of okay because he figured it out. You're a cute little horsey. Oh, you don't like that little ear that time, huh? It's the first little no I got on. Ooh, I got a little no. See that? See what a no looks like? That's a no. That's not fear. That's a no. I don't like horses that tell me no. So he doesn't get to tell me no. I get to grab it now and I'm holding his head. And I'm not holding a lot of pressure, but I'm giving him guidance saying you're not going to pull away. It is so mean. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure I end to where he's not saying no, so there's no connection that he thinks doing that made me stop. I don't want any confusion that by me throwing my head and pointing my nose and doing all that makes you stop. I don't want him to accidentally connect that. I want him to connect. I stop when I want to, not because of what he did. Ransom's giving some lessons today. Rick, he's so great. He's had professional training and he knows everything. Okay, whatever. You freaking people don't get it. I'm telling you, man. Horses, when you find out that a horse isn't good at something, you better find out on your terms like this than on his terms when you're not ready. Because it ain't nothing but trouble otherwise. She would stop, but that wasn't a no. See the difference? People don't understand how to read horses, and sometimes they, when they misread them and they force the horse to react, they're like, damn, that stupid horse. I didn't even do nothing. Why did he do that? You know, I could have went, that's stupid, Ransom. He flinched. I've reached for his face 1,000 times. He's never flinched, stupid horse. He flinched because I went too fast and I didn't give him a chance to be ready for me reaching. Ransom doesn't look too happy today. He's like, dude. All right, so let me try some poo-poo rake sacking out, because I hate horses when I'm cleaning poop that they act like it's a freaking rake monster. So let me clean this off through the grass to make sure there's no poop on here, because somebody would be like, you touched him with poop. Yeah, well, whatever. So I don't like horses that tell me no. They should just be like, whatever. Feels uncomfortable, but you can do it. I don't want them freaking out on the noise. I don't want to accidentally hit them. They get too close and they freak out. They'll be like, why are you sacking them out with a rake? Because crap happens with horses. And anything I can get him used to when he's with me to ignore, that's what I want. So let's see how he handles this. Sometimes these little claws feel like claws or fangs. And when you rub them over them, they'll freak out. They'll be like, oh, something's grabbing me. So he's doing okay. okay with that. What else?
All right. I just wanted to mess with him a little bit and tie him up. I don't know how long I've been going on. I needed some release after seeing all those poor horses at that so-called rescue. It's just freaking disgusting. All right, so they're standing there. I actually like that little red halter. It's got a nice little rubber thing on the end. I don't know who sent that to me, but that's rubber. The one that Ransom is wearing is the one I got from, what's that place? I had their website on my, I had their site on my site. I don't remember what it was. I think they're shut down for something, for some reason. People were like, I can't get rope halters for anymore. Well, there's plenty of people at rope halters, and as long as they don't put metal on that tip, I'm okay with them. And I didn't really adjust this one, so the knots are probably a little loose. Buddy will keep his head still. Yeah, they don't look too loose. And I like that little, that red rope I got, it really felt good in my hands, and I got it at some cell shop a long time ago, and I was like, man, that's my lead rope. I love it. If you use cell line, it's made to work in salt water, so the salt doesn't tear it up. It doesn't get stiff like the cheap ropes. It'll always stay soft. It'll last forever, and it's rated for thousands of pounds because it's holding big sails up, etc. So that's why I only use sail line when I buy my rope for my horses. I don't use buckles. If you notice, none of my ropes have buckles. It's got the end of the rope, and I just tie a little whipping on there with some paracord. And that's how I do my, on this one. On the end, you'll probably see some whipping there. I think I use some red rope on that one. Yeah. So I just put a little whipping on the end there. And no metal. I don't like metal on horses. So, all right. So I already gave them their. Oh, you know what? Buddy still likes his orange, and Ransom really didn't like the orange. So I'm gonna go give him an orange and see if Ransom will eat it. So, got my orange and I gotta peel it. I don't feed the peelings. I know some people say the peelings are the best nutrients, blah, blah, blah. I just don't give them that. I think that's too much acidic value. If they want an orange, they can eat it. Buddy loves the orange. Mr. T loved the orange. I tried to give it to Ransom the other day. He's like, what the hell are you feeding me, dude? You're trying to poison me. So he wasn't a fan of the orange. Let's see if he'll eat it today. This one isn't as juicy as the one the other day, man. The other one was really juicy. Buddy's like, dude, that looks so good. Feed me. Mmm.
Dad, how do you get a piece? I He's like, that horse is eating it, why can't I eat it? You sure? But he's gonna eat it if you don't. Uh-oh. That's the first one he bit, because he saw Buddy eating it. If he eats says he gets the last one. He ate it. Now he's going to be an orange fiend. Oh my goodness, it's so good. I know. I can't believe you didn't eat it. It's really juicy. Okay. But he's like, dude, why'd you eat that? I liked it when you weren't eating it. All right, so we'll give him a little carrots. Ever since I wormed him, he doesn't take food from me as quickly. But he gets a little pushy. This is what he does with the hay in the morning. He's all in my business. So he is a little... He's a little pushy if you don't watch him. That can turn into problems. Maybe that's why Buddy's getting in his butt.
Alright. So that's the Ransom and Buddy show. As the pastor turns nays of our lives with Buddy and Ransom doing the kissy. Buddy's like, dude, you ate some of my orange. That's some good shit. You must be part of the herd now. Let me look at their feet, see how their feet are doing. Not too bad. Not too bad. Buddy probably needs his feet done. Because I did him before Mr. T died. And Mr. T's been gone for almost a month. So I could probably... Rick, his rope's too long! He's gonna... Oh, that's what I was gonna do. I was gonna hobble him. I'll make that another video. Put a set of hobbles on little Ransom. My goodness, you're scratching hard, boy. Good thing there ain't no splinters on there. But he's like, dude, he's tearing up my type. But he's like, it's all right, man. If you can let me free, I'll let you tear it up. Crazy horse. See the little lines down his ribs where I raked him with that rake? Can y'all see that? Is that coming out? It almost looked like he's had a little, like little finger prints around along the side. He is just going to town on that itching. What are you itching for, boy? Buddy is due for his shots in September. I know a lot of people are like, why didn't you get his shots? Why didn't you check his shots? How do you know he's up to date? I don't care if he's up to date. It's kind of like they're telling you the coronavirus. Buddy, I'm watching you, boy. If my horse has their shots, I don't really care if he has his shots. So, before I get him his shots, you know, I got to check with the owner and make sure. Buddy, I'm going to beat you like... Quit biting on that horse. There ain't no damn sense in that. Now, that was kind of a little love bite, so I'm not, you know, even Ransom's kind of like, whatever, dude. That ain't even a bite. You're biting like a damn woman. So he ain't worried about it, but. All right. What the hell was I talking about before I did that? Oh, the shots. So in September, when I call the vet out, I'm going to have him bring enough for Belle across the street and then, or across the fence line. Buddy, Aunt Buddy, just use lips. No teethies. No teeth. You can use your lips. So little Belle just walked around a corner and Ransom saw her. She was in the back. Her owner's supposed to call me at 4 so we can do the worming. What time is it? 3:58. I'll give her 1 minute after 4 before I bug her. No, I'm like, whatever. She knows I have it. She said around 4. When she calls me, we'll do it. All right. We'll end that there, I guess. Ransom, Buddy, you guys are good boys. Buddy, Master T, you're good boys. Oh, I called the lady on the headstone for Mr. T. And they want $225 extra on top of the $425 to put a picture of him. But they're going to put a picture. I can either have a picture, an actual picture that they put in. They said porcelain, and it's glued in there. And I said, well, that fade? How long? She goes, we guarantee it for life. I go, really? She goes, yeah. Or she said forever. And I go, really? They don't fade? She goes, no. But she goes, I like the black granite better because it's actually carved into the granite. And some of those pictures look pretty cool. So I sent her a couple pictures of Mr. T, and she's going to tell me which one she thinks will do better and what it'll look like. So I might do the black granite with it engraved instead of the porcelain. If anybody's got any input on that, I would appreciate it. See, for those that don't get it, I was asking for input. Okay? Rick, you were telling everybody you didn't want to hear them and buy. What? Be quiet, you big crybabies. All right, so I could leave these guys here. I might go clean their water trough and put some bleach in there while they're tied up. If Buddy doesn't hang, so Ransom's like, hey man, my woman's calling. I got to go. Untie me, dude. I gotta go. These little forelocks are cute. What are you doing, buddy? Why are you acting like you're trapped and you're just itching to get over there to the mud to tear something up, aren't you? I noticed in the video the other day when I left, he was like pawing or something. When I was uploading, for some reason, I was putting a comment or trying to find a spot to put a comment or something. And I noticed he was pawing. I was like, that little shit, I turned my back and he's out here pawing. At this rescue, there was horses just standing and poop, pacing back and forth, swaying left, right, left, right, left. I mean, it was, oh God, I want to get it out of my mind, but it's just, it was so freaking irritating. All right. So, I know I said I was going to end it, so I might as well end it, I guess. Where's Moki Cat? He was up here a few minutes ago. He was laying on the fire thing, and he rolled over for me to pet him, and he forgot he wasn't on the ground. He slid right off. I caught him right before he hit the ground and bounced off. He was lucky. But he probably wouldn't have rolled over if I wasn't there, but still, I saved his life. He was like, thanks, Dad. I was on my way down. All right, so I think that's what I'll go do. I'm going to go clean that water bucket and leave them tied up. And you don't need to watch me clean a water bucket. Basically, I'm going to dump it. I'm going to rinse off if there's anything at the bottom. I'm going to spray it down with that 50% bleach and water. Let it set for 2 minutes. Rinse out the bleach and water and then fill it up with fresh water. All right, we're going to end that there. Bye, boys. Say goodbye to YouTubies. That's how I like good horses tying. I just got finished cleaning their water bucket. They're both standing there next to each other like good horses. Even the little hussy over there has been screaming and crying because you can't see him. Ransom is answering her, but he has not answered her verbally. But they're both being good boys standing there, so I'm going to go put them up now.